Automapper helps you to copy data from one object type to other object type. In other words, you can see that on my screen we have two classes here. One is a person class and the other one is the employee class. Now let us say that we want to transfer data from the person object to the employee object. So for example, now let us say you have created a person object here, and this person object you have loaded with some data. So let us say first name is equal to Shiv, and last name is equal to something, right? Now you want to move this data of the person object into the employee object. So let us say you have an employee object over here, and you want to move this first name and last name into this EMP object. So the way most of the developers will do is, you know, they will say, they will go property by property. So they will say emp.firstname is equal to person.firstname, right? And emp.lastname is equal to person.lastname. So they will map every property of the source object to the destination object. Now at the first glance, this does not look to be much of a problem. You know, you specify the source property, you specify the destination property, etc. But what if you want to use this mapping code again and again? So as a best practice, you'd like to centralize this mapping code in some central place, in some central library, and then you would like to reuse this mapping code again and again. And this is where exactly this our superhero Automapper comes to rescue. Automapper sits in between the source and the destination object like a bridge and maps the property data of both the objects. So in order to get Automapper, the first thing is you can go to your NuGet. So let us go to our NuGet packages and you can go and search Automapper. So you can see that in the NuGet you get this Automapper, a convention based object to object mapper. So go ahead and install this. Now using Automapper is a two-step process. The first thing is you go ahead and you create a map, and the second step is you use the created map. So the way you will go and create a map is, the first thing is you definitely need to go and import the Automapper namespace, and then you can say your mapper dot create map, right? So what is the source, right? So my source at this moment is the person, and what is the destination where you want to load the data? So that is employee, right? So I've created this map. So let us say if I want to use this, so I will say here employee emp is equal to mapper dot map. So map the destination. So my destination is employee, and the data is in this person object, right? So you can see here I have loaded this person object. So I'm passing the person object and saying that copy the data from the person object and transfer it to employee, right? So if I go and run this program, so let us say if I go and run this program here, there it goes. So it creates a map and it then uses the map. So you can see now in this employee object, you can see the Shiv and Kerala has been loaded from the person object. Now you must be wondering that how did it map from first name to last name, you know, without specifying any mapping. You can see that I specified only the class name here, but I did not specify that first name has to map with the other first name, right? Now, this happened automatically actually. If the property names are same, you can see now the between the class employee and the person, the first name and last name is same, so that's why it transferred the data automatically. But now let us say, what if the employee's first name is F name here, right, and the last name is L name, right? So what if the properties are different? So in that case, you know, your syntax of create maps has some more code here. So you can see here I'm using this for member, and this for member I'm saying that okay, my destination is a F name, so please map my source first name with the destination F name. please map my source last name with the destination L name, right? So in case your property names are different, then you need to use this for member function here, okay? So I'm going to go again and run this program, and let us say if the mapping happens, let us see if the mapping happens. And you can see that still the mapping is working, right? So some of the places, you know, where you will use Automapper is, you know, when you are moving data from a model to a view model in MVC, or when you're moving data from view model to model in MVC, or when you're moving data from DTO objects, that is data transfer objects, to entity objects, or when you're moving data from DTO objects to a model object. So these are, you know, some of the scenarios where you will use Automapper. So I hope that you enjoyed this lecture. So in this lecture, we were trying to understand what is Automapper and where we can use it in our projects. Thank you so much.